During the Great War 8,000 years ago, a lone Dracon prosecutor headed down to Mobius' surface, presumably on a scouting mission. In battle against a group of echidnas, it was Sonic who would be brought back to the past by Tikal, who defeated and captured the prosecutor. Later, however, while being interrogated by the echidnas, a Dracon army invaded the echidna capital of Megapolis City in an attempt to retrieve the recently stolen Chaos Emeralds. A squad of Dracon soldiers broke into the Emerald Chamber, and during the battle that followed, a stray laser blast struck the Chaos Emeralds. This caused an explosion of Chaos energy in the chamber, and the imprisoned prosecutor was caught in the blast, abandoned by his comrades. Somehow, the prosecutor survived, and the Chaos energy mixed with the water from his shattered prison mutated him into the monster we know as Chaos. Before he was able to go on a rampage, the echidnas managed to weaken Chaos and seal him away in a mystic container. Though, as was later revealed in Sonic the Comic Online, he managed to drag Tikal into the container with him, subjecting her to 8,000 years of torture while the two were merged. It was Robotnik who later discovered Chaos's container, but he came to understand that Chaos could not be controlled and never released him. Grimer, however, unaware of this and desperate to snap his master out of his suicidal depression, unleashed a monster upon the world. In this incarnation, Chaos is the purest of evil, with the ability to generate crippling levels of fear in anyone who gets too close. At first, the years of imprisonment had apparently reduced him to a bestial state, though his sentience was restored later. When he first attacked the Metropolis Zone, the Freedom Fighters eventually managed to drive him off, but not before the monster murdered Johnny Lightfoot. After this, he attacked the floating island in order to retrieve the Chaos Emeralds, claiming they were his by right. Luckily, before he could absorb more than one emerald, Knuckles jettisoned the rest, scattering them across the far reaches of Mobius. Watching over the events, Robotnik retrieved the emeralds and brought them to his summer retreat, using them to lure both Chaos and the Freedom Fighters to him as part of his suicide plan. With all of the emeralds in his possession, Chaos mutated into his perfect form. Now completely unstoppable, he had every intention of using his power to conquer Mobius and reshape it in his image. His downfall came from an unexpected source, Supersonic, who threw himself into Chaos, draining him of all his Chaos energy and reverting him back to his Dracon form. Just to add insult to injury, Supersonic threw Chaos out of the building where he landed in the water below, right by the spot where one Big the Cat happened to be fishing. It looked like that was the end of Chaos, but Nigel Kitching did have plans for the character before he learned the comic was to go fully reprint. Those ideas were developed in Sonic the Comic Online. Continuing where the story left off, Big rescued Chaos from the predators of Mobius' waters. Surprised, though not displeased, to meet a fish that could talk, Big nicknamed Chaos as Buddy, moments before the floating island was raised from the depths, carrying his boat up with it. After that, Chaos and Big formed an unlikely partnership. Chaos attempted to manipulate Big's kind but simple nature, enlisting his help to retrieve the Chaos Emeralds, even if it meant he had to commit the unspeakable act of asking nicely. Big also witnessed Rouge the Bat kidnap Porker Lewis and steal the Chaos Emeralds, so he teamed up with Knuckles and Tikal to track her down, with Chaos keeping out of sight. They followed her to the Haunted Hill Zone and used a ghost train to ride deeper into the zone. However, Rouge destroyed the tracks, sending the train off the rails and into a huge chasm. Knuckles was only able to get Tikal to safety, but somehow both Big and Chaos survived the fall. Chaos then attempted to enlist the help of the ghosts of the zone, believed them to be the spirits of Dracons who died in the Great War. What he hadn't expected, of course, was that the ghosts already had a leader, which Rouge sent after Knuckles and his companions. Afterwards, they managed to escape the caves and headed back to the mainland. But Big, who'd been commenting on his hunger earlier, couldn't help but lick his lips as he looked at Chaos. Sometime later, Big got his own solo adventure, where he accidentally ate all the food at a wedding reception for the mafia-like family. For this, he was marked for death by the family, and their top assassins were sent to eliminate him. Big surprised everyone, though, by showing himself to be a remarkably competent fighter. His naturally fast reflexes allowed him to catch bullets in mid-air. Not to mention he happens to be very strong, and finds some very creative uses for his fishing rod. Seeing that he had potential, the family offered him work so that he could pay off his debt over time. At first, Big refused to get involved with them, but eventually, after they sent even more assassins after him, he was forced to cave in and agreed to work for them. So nowadays, he works as the head chef at the family-run restaurant called Buddy's Bistro. He seems happy enough with his new job. As for Chaos, well, it turns out he's alive and well, now living in a fish tank at the same restaurant, and unable to intimidate anything larger than the other fish.